Hello everyone and welcome to today's session. Thank you for joining us for today's webinar on SME Section 9 Code Expert. My name is Sandeep Kumar, a welding professional and qualified IWE, IWB, WIPC, AWS EWI and MSc in Welding Engineering. This webinar will take around 40 minutes. If you have any question, please type in the chat box which will be answered at the end of the webinar. If due to time constraint any queries remain unanswered, it shall be resolved by email reply. So let us start our today's topic. In our earlier training, we have covered introduction to SME Section 9. Those who have missed it can watch on our YouTube channel. The link has been sent to you in the webinar confirmation email. Today we will cover SME Section 9, very important QG part which is for general requirement, and these general requirements are applicable to all part of Section 9. At the end of today's webinar we will learn when do you use Section 9, what does Section 9 covers, to understand the scope of the code, Section 9 organization and structure, what are the welding variable for procedure, process and special processes, what is WPS, QR and WPQ, and clause applicable to QG part and their understanding for practical use. By attending full training with attention and not skipping any part, you will not be a welding engineer, but for 100% sure, give you full confidence to work, get expertise, understanding with code, and you will able to train other on Section 9 code. And this is the most important task for a welding engineer. So let's first know who are the beneficiaries of this training program. This training program is equally important for welding engineers, welding inspectors, QAQC engineers, welding managers, quality managers, inspection engineers, third party inspectors, welding supervisor, fabricator and welder, and any other person who are dealing with SME Section 9. As we know, SME codes are divided in two parts. One is reference codes and the other is construction codes. As we can see here, construction codes are Section 1, which cover rules for construction of power boilers. Section 3 covers rule for construction of nuclear facility components. Section 4 is for construction of heating boilers. Section 8 covers for construction of power vessels. Section 12 is for rules for construction and continued service of transport tanks. Similarly, on our left hand side, we have reference code. And Section 2 cover materials, non-ferrous and ferrous, and welding consumables. Section 5 covers non-destructive methods, and Section 9, we will know in this training the scopes and what are the uses of ASME Section 9. So when other section refer to Section 9, so we say reference code only, but it has been referred by construction codes. So let's say some have additional requirement that given like Section 3 or Section 8, some reduced requirement like B31C sections, some have downstream requirements, for example B31 code section have specific requirement regarding filler metal that may be used in production. So learning is read the applicable construction code, it may contain requirements that affect qualification. This is especially true when impact testing is required, as Section 9 does not contain roughness acceptance criteria or requirements. So now let's know what is ASME Section 9. Section 9 of the ASME Boiler and Pressure Vessel Code relates to the qualification of welders, welding operators, brazers, brazing operators, and the procedure that they employ in welding and brazing activities. As we know, the user of Section 9 should be aware of how Section 9 is organized. It is divided into four parts: QG for general requirements, QW for welding requirements, QB for brazing requirements, and QF for plastic fusing requirements. Here QG stands for general requirement, QW for welding requirements, QF for plastic fusing, and QB for brazing requirements. So that is the main four part. Each part in assembly section 9 enters a material joining process, is then divided into articles. The articles for each material joining process, you can see here, are divided into article. Normally, a general requirements are specifically applicable to the material joining process, like article 1 welding, article 11 brazing, and article 21 for plastic fusing. The procedure qualifications are covered into article 2 for welding, article 12 for brazing, and article 22 for plastic fusing. And performance qualifications are covered into article 3 welding, article 13 brazing, and article 23 for plastic fusing. The general data for welding is given in article 4, article 14 for brazing, and article 24 for plastic fusing. The SWPS, also known as standard welding procedure specification, are given in article 5. Apart from four main part, we discuss SME section 9 include non-mandatory appendix, mandatory appendix, and suggested forms. Let us now start part QG, clause, for general requirement. But before, let's understand some terminology used in the code, which are very important in our training. The first is WPS, which means welding procedure specification. It is a qualified instruction for the qualified welder to complete the welding for which he is qualified. Second is PQR, stand for procedure qualification record, that is the actual record of welding parameter condition used for welding, the WPS test coupon, and the result of destructive and non-destructive testing as required by the SME section 9. Third one is WPQ, stand for welder performance qualification. A WPQ is a record of qualified welder qualification range and the result of test done for the welder qualification. So now let's move to the next part, which is QG 100. QG 100 of SME section 9 cover the scope of the code. So what is the scope? So let's know, section 9 of the SME boiler and pressure vessel code relates to the qualification of welder, welding operators, brazer, and brazing operators, and the procedure that they employ in welding and brazing activities for the construction under the rules of ASME BPVC and ASME B31 codes for pressure piping or any other codes, standard, or specification that reference to this standard. So section 9 does not deal with fabrication or inspection because it is a reference code, except that it specifies the minimum content of welding procedure that are used for fabrication or production welding. So it is reference code only. Section 9 is different from other standard where qualification and construction are integrated in one document, for example D1.1, 1.2 series or API 1104, which cover full scope of construction as well as qualification. Further, as we know, scope is having 5 parts. So under QG 100B, Whenever there will be conflict between referencing code, standard or specification and this section, that is 9, the requirement of the reference code, standard or specification shall take precedence over the requirement of this section. Similarly, QG100C tell, whenever the word pipe is used in the code, tube shall also be applicable. So both are same item. QG100D state, new addition to section 9 become mandatory 6 months after the date of issuance. QG100E state, court case are permissible and may be used beginning with the date of approval by ASME. Here, if you want to know what is the difference between code, standard or specification, you can watch one of our video available on our YouTube channel. Next part is QG101, that is for procedure specification. So this is applicable for all part for QW, QB and QF. So as we discussed, what is WPS, QG101 define a procedure specification as, it is a procedure specification, is a written document providing direction to the person applying the material process. The name of procedure specification is based on specific application as, it is called WPS under QW, Bridging Process Specification under QB and Fusing Procedure under QF. So let's know there are some notes. A procedure specification is either a qualified WPS or a SWPS. It must be available to the place of fabrication for the reference and review. WPS shall contain all the essential and non-essential variables applicable for process for which WPS is made. Also supplementary essential variable when applicable. Organization shall be responsible for this specification. It is the responsibility of organization. One WPS may be supported by one or more PQR. Like we know, one WPS can have multiple PQR. Next clause is QG102, which is related to the procedure qualification record. So the purpose of qualifying the procedure specification is to demonstrate that the joining process proposed for construction is capable of producing joints having the required mechanical properties for the intended application. As stated earlier, PQR document what occurred during the welding of a procedure qualification test and the testing result of that coupons. Few notes on QG102 are, as we discussed, a PQR demonstrate the mechanical properties of weld joint, note the skill of the welder who produced weld. The organization shall certify the PQR by signature or other means as described in the organization quality control system. PQR shall be available for review but not for reference, which means it need not to be at the place of fabrication. Like WPS, we have to keep at the welding site for reference as well as for review. But PQR is a document only for review and hence it does not need to be kept at the place of welding. One WPS can have multiple PQR and vice versa. Our next topic is clause QG103 for performance qualification. QG103 is for WQT, known as welder qualification test. The purpose of qualifying the person who will use a joining process is to demonstrate that person's ability to produce a sound weld when using a procedure specification or called WPS or welding procedure specification. We are using term WPS in place of procedure specification, as most of section 9 scope is related to welding only. So as shown in this picture, we need a weld with soundness for WQT. Let's move to our next topic, QG 104, which cover performance qualification record or WPQ. The performance qualification records document what occurred during the welding of a test open by a person using one or more joining processes following an organization WPS. We will discuss the format, essential variables, and test in the Article 3 training. WPQ shall be available for review but not for reference, which means it need not to be at the place of fabrication like WPS. As a minimum, the record shall document essential variables, range of variable qualified, result of required ND, identification of the procedure specification followed during the test. Next clause is QG 105, which is very important part of SME section 9, that is variables. So let us know the variables. The SME section 9 variable are defined into QG 105. So the variable are mainly divided into three types. First is essential variable, second is non-essential variable, and third is supplementary essential variable. So essential variable are those which significantly affect weld mechanical properties, and they must be recorded on both the WPS and PQR. PQR also must support the WPS values. Non-essential variable, they do not significantly affect weld mechanical properties, but they must be recorded on the WPS, but they are optional on PQR. The third one, supplementary essential variable, they are related to the toughness. So if there is a toughness requirement for the weld, then supplementary essential variable become essential variable. So we can see with example of this picture, we can correlate it with our variables in welding. If we don't meet all variable, it will affect the growth of a plant. Similarly, if we have good control on our welding variable, we can have a desired quality of the weld in terms of mechanical properties as well as soundness. So SME section 9, QG 105.1, define the essential variable as: essential variable are condition in which a change as described in the specific variable is considered to affect the mechanical properties other than toughness of the joint. And these are for they are applicable for procedure. Next is QG 105.2, essential variable for performance, which means essential variable are condition in which a change as described in the specific variable list will affect the ability of the person to produce a sound joint. So they are related to the ability of a welder to produce a sound joint. The next is QG 105.3, supplementary essential variables. These variables are conditions in which a change will affect the toughness properties of the joint in heat affected zone or base metal. When a then a weld required toughness, this supplementary essential variable will become essential variable as we discussed. Next is QG 105.4, non-essential variable. These are the conditions in which a change as described in the specific variable is not considered to affect the mechanical properties of the weld. So for example, a joint design in SME is considered as a non-essential. So one WPS qualified with groove weld, it can be used with different type of groove. Next is QG 105.5, special process variables. These are the variable that apply only to special process that I described in the part that address those processes. When these special process are used, only the applicable special process variable shall apply. For example, when there is a requirement for hard facing or corrosion resistance overlay, the variable are different than normal welding process. All these variable, they are defined into QW 250 also. So to brief, essential variable for procedure are those variable when they change will affect the mechanical properties of a weld joint. For example, one WPS is qualified with one type of filler wire classification, so it's not allowed to change to other type of welding wire because the other wire will have different welding properties. So if change is required, a new WPS has to be qualified. Similarly, for essential variable for performance is, here the purpose is to about the soundness of the weld quality. So a welder, he can use another filler wire, and as long as he is a good welder, he will able to deposit a sound weld with a different wire also. But then his ability will change. For example, for welder, essential variable is a position. So he is good into 1G position, so he may not able to weld in a vertical weld. Supplementary essential variable are those affect the toughness, and non-essential we have already discussed. So let us move to our next part, QG 106. Let us start our next part, QG 106, which define the organization responsibilities. Here the organization responsibilities are defined in three area. The first is for procedure qualification, second is for performance qualification, third is for simultaneous performance qualification. The last year edition of SME Section 9 come with new guideline related to personal performing supervisory activities specified in this section, that is for welding engineer, that they must be designated by the organization with the responsibility of for certifying qualification document. They should have a satisfactory level of competency in accordance with organization quality system, and they should have a defined education experience requirement. All their training record and qualification record and their objectives shall be maintained by the company. The next is QG 106. Here the simultaneous performance qualification responsibilities for a organization are defined. Let's move to next part, QG 107, which state the ownership transfer information. As it said, multiple organization under a common ownership may use PQR, WPS and performance qualification record under that owner name. New owner may acquire these document without requalification. Following conditions shall be met. They should take responsibility. WPS identify name of new owner, QC system and QA program document original source. So for example, a one company bought other company, the new company can use the document of old company. Next part is QG 108. This is a qualification made to previous edition of SME section 9. So it's like I can say that what is the life of AWPS. So QG 108 state that welding process specification, procedure qualification record, and welder or welding operator performance qualification made in accordance with the requirement of 1962 edition or any later edition of section 9 may be used in construction for which the current edition has been specified and hence do not need to be amended. So qualification of new procedure specification of joining process and performance qualification of person applying them shall be in accordance with the current edition of section 9. So once WPS and PQR are qualified, they are good for pretty much forever except when impact are required. So go back. So they may be updated to later edition of the code at the manufacturer or contractor option, assuming data was recorded that support that revision. But all new qualifications have been made to current edition. So there is one condition about it, says except as specified in QW 420. So let's know what is this. So when base metal are reassigned to another P number by code in QW 422, for example P5 become P5A, P5B and P5C around 2001. So all PQR listing the reassigned base metal as a test coupon need to be examined and the WPS they support need to be revised to show the new P number for new work. So we don't need to make a new PQR, we can just revise them because our PQR is still valid. So based on that PQR, the PQR will have a P5 number, but in our WPS we have to revise and give a number P5A. Thank you for watching our today webinar. We will be back soon with our next part on QW welding requirements. We will reply to any queries in the chat box, and also if anything we right now we are going to finish this, so we will try to revert by email for the pending queries. Thank you very much.